Okay. Next on the agenda is authorizing the mayor to send a letter of support of the Transportation Authority of Marin's effort to seek state of California legislation providing an exemption to the Marin County regarding the 2% cap on the local transaction and use tax. So basically, it's kind of a procedural thing that the Transportation Authority of Marin is requesting, and here we have Stephanie Moulton-Peters from Mill Valley, and also Transportation Authority. I think you're standing in for Diane Steinhauser right now, right? And press the button on the little, there you go.
Am I on? Very
yep,
good.
Yep, you're on.
Okay, good
take
evening,
it away.
Fairfax. It's really great to be with you tonight. I am the president of the board of the Transportation Authority of Marin County. That's our congestion management and transportation financing agency. I'm standing in tonight for our executive director. And I'm here just to share some brief comments. I came with PowerPoints and handouts and all that, and I really think we can just have a very straightforward conversation. I'll tell you what this is all about, and then I'm happy to answer your questions. I want to compliment your staff on their staff report. It was excellent. I intend to use it when I go to Mill Valley for our staff report, so thank you. It's just very clear. I'd also like to acknowledge I'm here tonight with Molly Graham, our public outreach coordinator from TAM, and she's a wonderful partner in all of this. So where are we? Just briefly. We, as you know, the Transportation Authority of Marin passed in 2004 a local sales tax, half-cent sales tax, which generates local funding that we can control for local transportation and transit projects, and we also use this funding to leverage opportunities to win state and federal grants. In the old days, state and federal funding used to comprise the bulk of our transportation funding in Marin County. That is no longer the case, and our local funds are the largest source of transportation funding in Marin County now. Our sales tax sunsets in 2024, and then we would need to renew it. So why am I standing before you talking about this in 2017? We are hoping to go forward and renew this tax next year in 2018. Sometimes it takes a two-thirds majority vote to pass. Those can be difficult. In the case that we don't pass, we'll have another chance to go for it. And we also know that SMART is thinking of going to renew its sales tax in 2020 or 2024. So we're trying to get a little ahead of the curve on this. Measure A funds things like our wonderful Safe Routes to School program that started right here in Fairfax. Over 50% of Measure A has gone to providing transit services, buses, senior mobility, and now a little bit of school bus funding. We also fund major roads and local roads. Every city and town in Marin County receives funds each year for local road maintenance. Now, the truth of the matter is most of our funds are committed to these existing programs. Really, less than 15% is up for new projects. When we go to renew, we still want to do safe routes. We still want to do transit. We still want to do buses and local roads. So there is an idea that there may be community support for not only renewing, but perhaps increasing this sales tax, as a number of counties have done. In order to do that, we are right close to the top of the maximum sales tax that can be levied. And what do I mean by that? In California, the state of California itself can levy up to 7.5% in taxes that go to the state. The local governments have an additional 2% in taxes that each city and town and the county can decide to use for sales tax purposes for local projects and services. In Marin County, both your wonderful city and the city of San Rafael are very close to the maximum of the 2% additional. You have here a quarter cent less. I know you know this because you've been through your local issues recently. You have a quarter cent in taxing ability left. So does the city of San Rafael. That quarter cent would also be available to the Transportation Authority, a county organization, to use if we extended and expanded the sales tax program. We don't want to take away your ability to use your quarter cent sales tax in the future if you so choose. We don't want to compete with you or San Rafael on that. It is possible for transportation measures, pretty much only, the governor will grant an exception to this 2% local sales tax cap. It requires special legislation to do it. And so, out of sort of fairness, the Transportation Authority has said, we would be interested in sponsoring this legislation with our local senator. Not that it means we're going to pass it, we're not asking you to approve an increase. It is to give us the ability to have a conversation with the whole Marin County community about our transportation needs in the future. Do we simply want to renew our sales tax at the current level, or do we have some additional needs for which we would entertain an increase when we go to renew that sales tax? Would it be a quarter cent increase, 3/8, half cent? We don't know, because we need to go through the whole expenditure plan process, which we are just kicking off now at the Transportation Authority. All of the cities and towns will be solicited for input. There will be community meetings this coming year. So in coming to you now, it may seem a little cart before the horse to ask for your support to your mayor to write a letter saying, we are supportive of special legislation that would give us an exemption from the 2% local tax cap for up to a half cent more in sales tax if and when and after all of the cities and towns agree on an expenditure plan and agree on a sales tax level to renew at. Okay, that's a lot of information. Maybe I'll stop there and ask for questions.
Just a quick question. So the maximum tax that folks in Marin County would then face is 10%?
No, I think it's 9.7.
It would be 9.75?
Correct.
Okay, so that would be the max if the cap was raised and you went to your maximum amount that you are thinking about at this time?
Yes, and you went to your maximum amount.
Okay, and the other point is just to reiterate what we've been, I'm sure, been getting emails in all day from folks, far and wide, actually, saying don't raise taxes, So I want to give TAM the opportunity to clarify, as you did just a few seconds ago, to say that no, where this is not a tax question today. This is allowing the opportunity to have a tax question down the road.
That's exactly right, Council Member. And I am very supportive to hearing all points of view, including those that do not want to raise taxes at all. And there will be opportunities down the road in our process to hear those comments, to weigh them in the costs and benefits in the expenditure plan process. It's only fair to identify the projects that we want to fund, what their costs are, and to put it out to the community, you know, is this something they would support or not? So we will be going through that process. We want all voices to be heard. But at this moment in time, we are not asking for a tax increase at all. We are asking for legislation that would allow us to have the conversation of what level we want to renew at.
And just to reiterate or to bring forward a point that I think you made very clearly, is that if we do not raise the tax, not that Fairfax has an interest in raising its sales tax at this time, we've gone through that quite expansively over the last couple of years, you would swallow the ability of Fairfax and San Rafael, in fact, to have the option to raise taxes should it need to do so. So let's take the example of a natural disaster. And we needed to have an infusion of taxes of one sort or another. It would not be possible unless this went through or other similar legislation. So in other words, it's a question of tax availability and tax flexibility.
That's absolutely correct. And we at TAM want to preserve and protect the individual cities and towns' ability to raise that last increment of funds should you need it in a disaster or otherwise, and you never know what's on the horizon. So we really want to leave that for you to decide for your needs when and if you need it.
And Barbara had a question too.
So thanks, Stephanie. So it sounds like TAM is willing to do the heavy lift to basically up the cap without any proposed tax in mind. That's
yes,
correct.
That is correct.
Okay. Well, regardless of that, so ultimately, I'm sure TAM is willing to do the lifting because they really do want to move forward maybe in the subsequent year to renew. I mean, this staff report is slightly confusing to me because it seems to be saying that TAM wants to move forward with a renewal and possible increase in this next election year, but it's just to clarify, you just want to raise the cap, period.
Yes, that's okay. Correct. And this is confusing because we have two processes going on simultaneously. The legislative process, we are at the beginning of the new state legislative season, the two-year season. So this is the year, 17-18, when new bills would be introduced. And we are under some time pressure right now to work with Senator McGuire to introduce a bill in February that would accomplish this objective. So the bill, there are other ways to introduce bills later, frankly, if we need to. But that is the legislative track that would go forward this year, and either one or both houses would approve this year. Additionally, in a separate process is our expenditure plan process that TAM would run. And that's where we develop the inventory of projects and the costs and then go out to the community and the voters to see what their appetite and priorities are.
Okay, so I have one question, but just to clarify, it's not a two-year process. So bills have to be introduced by a certain date this year, and they would be considered this year. They may turn into two-year bills.
Yes.
But Senator McGuire, as we've all followed, those of us who read the IJ, has been supportive of Senate Bill 1, I believe, which is a bill to fund transportation infrastructure through upping the gas tax, and I think it's $100 reg fee for e-vehicles, an additional fee. And that would raise several billion dollars. So part of me says I like to see where that goes this year. I mean, fully understanding that the cap is a potential issue, but I think even with Fairfax and San Rafael at 9%, we still have a quarter cent left to go, which allows the county, for example, to put forth the child program that didn't pass. But I guess my thoughts are is TAM could start working on the expenditure plan. Just one thought would be, let's wait on the cap because it could happen next year if needed. But TAM could start working on an expenditure plan with those projects so we could really see. In the staff report, I see that we've gotten maybe about $100,000 out of TAM money, which is nothing to sneeze at, but it's not huge. And so I would like to kind of see where SB 1 goes this year. I think the governor's really going to be pushing this to see where we can get with transportation infrastructure monies that would also come to Marin County, and have TAM go along the parallel path of really putting that expenditure plan together and doing community meetings with the thought of not necessarily pushing for the cap at this point.
That's so, if I might, you make excellent points. Let me give some additional information. It is true that SB 1 is going through, and Senator McGuire has been very supportive of that. The estimates that I've seen is, I come from a small city, as you do, that the number, so the larger cities stand to gain a couple million dollars each for San Rafael and Novato out of that allocation should that bill pass. The other number I saw was Corte Madera, and I don't know this population comparison, but they stand to gain about $325,000 from this bill. It's nothing to sneeze at, and Fairfax and all the other cities would gain something too. So that's a plus, but it doesn't go much farther than that. What didn't come to Fairfax directly, but you certainly benefit from, are the fixes to the major roads going on, Sir Francis Drake, the western portion that was finished, the eastern portion that it will be started. Those are our major road projects. And you may not know that when the first Measure A was passed, a whole list of all the major arterials in Marin County was prioritized by our predecessors on the TAM board and in the cities and towns in the county, with the idea that the sales tax would fund upgrades to all these major corridors. Truth be told, in the last 10 plus years, we worked on four or five of them only, and there's like 20. And so San Anselmo and Sausalito and Ross and Belvedere and Corte Madera did not get any major road allocation at all. Mill Valley benefited. Our Miller Avenue program is funded with this major road money. We have $13 million that came to us. These are the really big projects. So just as the Sir Francis Drake corridor was totally redone a few years ago, you'll see that and those kinds of improvements. You would also see in a Measure A renewal the possibility of redoing the hub. And major projects like that, not necessarily in your jurisdiction, but of benefit to your jurisdiction. So that's one piece of information, and there wouldn't be enough funding coming from the state bill to accomplish those. There isn't enough funding coming at any level to accomplish what we need to accomplish, frankly. In terms of the timing, here's the way the expenditure plan process looks. We have just started an oversight committee of the board that I appointed. We will appoint an expenditure plan committee of different stakeholder groups, geographic, balance. We'll be looking to you and your council for input as to who should be on it, business, labor, the whole thing. That committee will work to develop a expenditure plan of all the projects that and will be soliciting project requests from all the cities and towns in the county. They will poll the public, they will do community meetings, and then we will come back and see what is there an appetite for. They will put together an expenditure plan by the early part of next year. The plan will come to your council and all the other councils. It must be approved by all the councils in order to qualify for the ballot in June. So that's the problem with waiting until next year to look at this sales tax cap exemption, is that we're going to be really far down the road, and right at this June deadline, is June or August. Anyway, it has to happen next summer. So we want to tackle this legislative thing this year if we possibly can, because it, again, gives us the airspace, if you will, to have a conversation on what if we were able to go beyond straight renewal.
Just one quick question. So since Measure A doesn't expire till 2025?
24, yes.
Oh, well, our staff report has a little glitch in
okay.
there. But 2024 is the urgency of getting the expenditure plan together because we just we haven't been able to fund projects that are really needed. Is that because the expiration is not the urgency?
Yeah, it's both, Barbara. Two-thirds majorities, as we have seen this last county election, don't always happen. And when they don't, you have to regroup and go out again. I mean, it's crucial that we renew this sales tax, at least across the board, the way it is right now. As I said, 55% of the current sales tax goes to our bus district, Marin Transit. If we lose that source of funding, we lose our bus system. If some of the commenters had good comments, it doesn't go as far and as often as they'd like now, it'll be decimated if we don't renew that sales tax. So we're trying to play a conservative game to go early to the ballot on the unfortunate chance that it doesn't pass. And we have had great success with the Yellow School Bus program. And we've only begun to scratch the surface of providing that throughout the county as a congestion management tool. In your area, you all have been on school buses longer and more than where I come from in Marin County. We're trying to catch up. There isn't funding to offer yellow school bus service everywhere. We'd like to make that available because it really is making a difference in traffic on our roads. So I think we're just trying to get out of the gate, you know, early and have these conversations and tee them up.
Thank you, Stephanie.
Sure.
Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Just quick for clarification, did you say in your original presentation that we're looking at renewal in 2018?
Thank you for the question. Let me make a distinction. There's two ways we can go, a straight renewal or a renew and expand.
So I get that, but it doesn't expire until 2024, so I'm trying to understand the 2018 mark.
So again, as Councilmember Kohler said, it does seem early to go to the game. We know that SMART is going to try and come fairly soon also for their renewal so that they have some breathing room. So 2018 is before our current sales tax expires. That is true.
Okay, maybe I'm just not understanding. So we would just be renewing it prior to its sunset.
And it would take effect when the other one sunsets.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay, and the other thing is, so I know that, and it was pointed out through multiple emails, that San Rafael did not approve the mayor sending the letter to support this. So what's the implications
of that? They actually tabled their discussion. They didn't vote up or down. They want more information. So they have left it hanging at this point in time. They did not give the mayor, they were taking a resolution effect. So they didn't pass a resolution, but they didn't turn it down. They want to approach it again in the future.
In the future, though, like you said that it would require that all of the jurisdictions would be on board with this to take it to the ballot. And if one doesn't,
right,
or multiple, does that kill it for everyone, or how does that work?
So, again, two different processes. Right now, this is about what is more of an administrative matter to sponsor legislation at the state level, which would approve the possible increase of our sales tax cap 0.5%. So that's one process. And then the expenditure plan process, and it is true that the expenditure plan, the final plan for how we want to spend this money, must be approved by all cities and towns and the county in order to qualify for the ballot.
Okay, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to get to a real clear understanding.
Fine.
So in terms of the cap, though, wouldn't that require, because that would be a county-wide decision.
So here's the skinny on that. It would be no, it does not require every jurisdiction. And in fact, other counties, Monterey County, Contra Costa County, Alameda County, San Mateo County, and the others listed in your staff report have all gotten special legislation to raise their sales tax cap for transportation purposes only. This is the one that seems to be approved. Nothing else really gets through. A number of those counties have just had their equivalent of the Transportation Authority of Marin and the county sponsor this legislation. It can be done at the county level. Senator McGuire has asked to see a show of support from all of the Marin jurisdictions up front. It's a little unusual, frankly, but we're going to honor his request, and that's why we're here early, out of the gate, before a lot of things are formed. We, again, could have done this at the county level and not had to burden you with this and come to you with just the what would you like in this in the expenditure plan, and will you vote to approve that? So this is an extra layer for cities and towns to do.
The piece I'm missing.
Did I give you too much information?
No. I'm getting it. But the piece that I'm missing is that in discussing cap, you point out that the other counties did, but that were there parts of their county jurisdiction, cities and towns that did not vote to exempt? Do you understand what I'm saying? I mean,
so
what if Puerto Madera said no?
But wait a minute. All this is a support letter for Senator McGuire for a piece of legislation. We're not voting.
No.
He wants letters of support before he goes forward with the legislation, because it helps him sell it to the rest of the Senate.
No, yeah. I understand that there are people who don't want to pay those taxes that are saying, if you do this now, you're opening us up to a bunch of stuff that we don't even know what it is, and we don't want it. So it's a blocking, but what I want to understand is, what if Fairfax just said, no way? So what would happen at the rest of, I mean, the county?
If you said no way tonight.
No, not tonight.
No way to expanded transportation program or sales tax?
No, to...
Here.
Does anybody know what
I'm trying to say? Let me try to explain this a different way.
So there's two things.
Yeah.
What they want is a support letter for the legislation for Senator McGuire, who may or may not decide to put forth the legislation if he doesn't feel he has that. The second part of it is that TAM wants to put together an expenditure plan to go forward with a ballot measure next year that would renew or potentially increase that. And I think Renee's question is, at that point, if Fairfax says no, San Rafael says no, what happens?
Then we don't, excuse me. Was that your question? Yeah, thank you for that. Then we would not go forward with the sales tax renewal next year if there was not unanimous support.
But Stephanie, you tell us quite well. You take us back a little bit. Of history, but you didn't tell us exactly, and the communities, I think, as you visit them, might want to know how we got into this ditch in the first place. And we can look back at those who voted back in the late 1970s to Prop 13. And we decided, or they decided as a community, that we would have a pay-as-you-go a la carte approach to funding government. And so here we are today. I often tell the tired story of my parents who had a tree pass away, or a branch pass away on a tree in the property in the city's right of way where they grew up in New York, and 11 guys showed up in a truck to make sure that they had the proper burial. We don't do that. We have the most lean and skinny approach to local government, particularly here, that anybody could possibly imagine, and provide essential services. If we want something special, like roads without potholes or yellow buses or fill in the blank of all those things, we have decided we're going to pay for them on the a la carte approach. This is that a la carte approach. So to me, the folks in San Rafael, I have nothing but the highest regard for our council colleagues and the mayor there, should really be thinking about the fact that we entered into, our forebears entered into that social compact. That social compact requires us to now provide the funding for the social services, and, or at least to provide the avenue to have that conversation. So for any city at this point to sort of be reticent at the get-go, seems to break faith with the concept under Prop 13 as it was originally imagined.
Yeah, thank you for those comments. I appreciate it. We did start from behind the curve. I'm also sensitive as a fellow elected. There is always pressure to do more with less and concern about raising taxes. That is absolutely the case, and I face that in Mill Valley. And so every council member wants to feel like they are making a prudent judgment on behalf of their community, and I support and respect that. And that is why before we adopt any sales tax strategy and level, we are going to have a very robust community process. And I promise, I've signed up for this. The next 2 years of my life, we're going to be doing this. But we are going to get out to the community the way it was done in 2004 when Steve Kinsey led this. And we will have these conversations and we'll have the debates about what's prudent. And we will come to a consensus about what all the cities and the county feel is supportable and necessary and a balanced request that we think our community will support. Now, let me give you a little bit of good news, a little sneak peek. We actually, at one point, thought that we were going to try to do all this 2 years ago and go for the presidential election, which we all know is a good time to go when you have high voter turnout. So we did some polling. We did some polling in the Marin County community, and just going out the door saying, how would you feel if we went out and renewed and raised the sales tax by a quarter cent, and more transportation services and senior mobility and more highway projects and all. Do you know what the response was? 68% support. 68%, 2 years ago, we still weren't out of the depression, recession, and there was no voter information out there. This was just a cold call. So traffic has gotten worse, not better, since then. And I hear about requests all the time. So I'm feeling that we're starting probably from a good place in terms of voter interest. But again, we will go through the process to really ferret that out. I promise we will not hang you out to dry, Renee. Because, no, the pressure for electeds is very real right now to manage our dollars wisely and make up for the dollars that we didn't get.
Yeah, and if I may interrupt, well, this whole process, which is, you know, so it's a long conversation. It's a complex conversation, and I, you know, thank everybody for sitting here and listening to it. You know, and it's got a lot of small stages, and I think we're at the first stage of that, and what you're asking for is a letter to start exploring these different stages so we can go methodically and carefully. I know that people ask me all the time, how come, you know, Drake is falling apart here and they're fixing it in other places, and, you know, basically there isn't enough money, even though we're trying to squeeze it from here and there, and we have budgeted some of our money here to do the worst of it. But it's a long, complex conversation. I'd like to kind of cut to the chase that we still need to open this up to the public.
I have a question.
And
sure.
Peter has a question too. Yeah. So yeah. I just kind of want to move it along.
Very good.
Thank you, Mayor. Can I get just some clarification on the numbers? Garrett, what's with the passage of Measure C, at Fairfax is at what? Are we at 9% or 9.25%?
Because the state dropped to 7.25%, we're at 9.
We're at 9, okay. And the current cap for Marin County is what?
9.25. 9.25.
9.25. And so then the proposed cap would be 9.75?
That's correct.
Okay, and currently TAM's sales tax is 0.25%, is that correct, Stephanie?
0.5 cent.
Oh, it's 0.5 cent.
It is.
Okay, and are you proposing raising it to 0.75 cent?
The proposal on the table is to explore up to a full 0.5 cent, and that in the expenditure plan process, the committee will look at 0.25 cent, 0.375 cent, so increments, and what would that get us?
I'm sorry, that doesn't answer my question, though. So currently, TAM is at a 0.5 cent.
Correct.
And then you're looking at how much are you considering raising the TAM's sales tax to?
So that hasn't been decided.
What is the range that is being contemplated?
The upper range is another 0.5 cent, which would bring it to a full cent.
So that one cent.
Yeah, that's the upper cent. It's entirely possible, Peter, that we would end up at 0.75. And none of that's been worked out. We just want to have some space for a conversation about all this.
Some headroom, as they say.
Correct. Exactly. Headroom. Perfect.
So, and you're contemplating possibly increasing the sales tax for TAM as soon as 2018?
Yes.
Okay. And then I was just curious, what is the, how much of TAM funds have gone to SMART, separate and apart from SMART sales tax funds?
Measure A is prohibited from spending funds on SMART specifically. We can spend other sources of money on SMART, and we did. You weren't on the council perhaps at that point, but when the Greenbrae interchange project some 4 years ago did not go through, we had some bridge toll funding that we receive. It's called RM2 funding. Some of that funding was reallocated to SMART, but we do not use our locally generated funds on SMART. It is a question going forward whether we would like to do that on a going forward basis, but we do not include that in Measure A at this time.
And what is a SMART sales tax? Is it a quarter?
It is a quarter cent.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
And I guess, Peter, if I might, our current 0.5 cent sales tax generates $25 million a year. We have just given San Rafael some state-generated money, close to a couple $1 million to put in sidewalks on East Francisco. And I say that just to underscore, these projects are expensive. So $25 million may sound like a lot of money. Half of it goes to transit. That's off the table. So we have something like $13 million. Some of that goes to safe routes. Some of it goes to your local roads. We burn it up pretty quick with what we do. So thank you.
Great. So if there's no further clarifying questions, maybe we should hear from the public.
Very good.
And Suzanne, would you like to be the first?
I went to those meetings in 2004. I was promised wonderful bus service. It was going to be even better than what I have now. What I got is, frankly, if I could use a bad word, it's S-H-I-T. And every month it gets worse. And I don't really see, and I'm on a fixed income. Like this year I got less than 1% in a raise from a federal employee, retiree. And my health insurance went up, and because I don't get Social Security, even though I worked there for 32 years, counting my Peace Corps and my Teach for America and all that, I never paid in, they don't let you get Social Security, even if you pay into it. So my Medicare is $160 a month when everybody else's is $106. So, because I'm considered rich or something, I can't really afford even another quarter percent of sales tax. I voted no on the Fairfax one because, okay, what it does to people like me is we don't go shopping here. We start shopping online where we don't have to pay sales taxes. Or we go to some other county and buy it. I mean, we don't go out for dinners. We don't go to the movies. We don't go. My husband and I already have cut back on where when we eat out. And because we like Japanese food and we can get it for 10 bucks, we go down, instead of having date nights, we have date lunches. But he's a school crossing guard just to make his very small post office after 30 years pension have us so we could take trips to Europe and see our relatives and have a good time. But we don't go to Europe like normal people that fly first class and stay in nice hotels. And we hang out with friends I know from school when I went there and rent crappy apartments. So, well, they're actually nice apartments, but, you know, we do it on the cheap. I shop at Saks, you know, I buy all my clothes secondhand when I can. So I'm just saying, I don't think that you should do this to seniors, and you have a lot of seniors living in Fairfax. And they're just like me on fixed incomes, and sometimes we can't even fix our faucets because plumbers cost too much, so we wait till some relative with a right kind of wrench comes to fix it. You know, it's things like that. You don't think about it when you're working. Oh yeah, the taxes are this. I was working in 2004, so I thought, oh great, you know, when I retire, I'll be able to zip all around the, all these different places and go see my friends, go have lunch with them, hang out, go to a movie. I can't go to movies that night anymore by myself. Tonight I walked down here and got soaked because there aren't any buses. So that's my thing. I mean, I think there's a lot of people that would say, no, don't raise this tax any more than a quarter percent. Thank you. And besides, we pay for SMART, which I call the dumb train, because I don't know anybody in Santa Rosa who's going to take a train, get off the train, get on a ferry. Do you know how expensive that is, paying all those fares? It's quite a bit.
Thanks.
Hi, how's everyone doing? Yeah, the happy Fairfax resident. Mark Bell, 63 Domingo. That was one of the most disingenuous presentations I've ever experienced. You know that they're going to raise the sales tax a half percent, if not more. Once they get this cap, if they can get an exemption to it, where does it end? Like everything else, once it starts you start going down that slope, it's never going to stop. It's been proven for years that sales taxes are the most regressive ones. We continue to go to them all the time. Now I'm hearing 3/8, 1/8, 1/16. Anything to get another chunk of money from people who live here. Secondly, I've been to Transportation Authority of Marin meetings. Totally untransparent, totally disgusting. And I wrote a letter and read it there about that, and about how they couldn't even answer a simple question about who was paying who what. A very simple question that refused to be answered. There's no transparency there. They give money to SMART. You hear, oh, there's no money for this, there's not enough money for that, there's not enough. They've given SMART hundreds of thousands of dollars. I don't really care if it's not Measure A funds, it's still funds that go through them. And those funds were voted on to give to SMART by people who have a conflict of interest, who are usually also on the SMART board, who did not recuse themselves. The entire action was illegal, but they don't police themselves and no one else will. I don't think we should give any letter in support of the Transportation Authority of Marin. They're not transparent. I don't see any clarity. I don't see any honesty from them. And I don't see why someone can't get up here and say, look, we want to raise the sales tax another half percent. This is how we have to go about it, because that's what they want to do, if not more. She talks about smart raising theirs. So what, we have a battle of transportation agencies trying to suck more money out of everyone? They can't even find a train engine that, a company that builds a train engine that works. What's the technology on a train engine? 200 years? Smart can't even do that right, but they keep sucking money out of everyone? It's enough. It's absolutely enough if it's not already too much. So I am totally opposed to writing a letter in support of this. Thank you.
Good evening. Diana Perdue, 199 Scenic Road. And I'm here to ask you not to support this either and not to write a letter to TAM so that they can go to Sacramento with Fairfax blessing. I think if TAM already knows that 7 years from now they're going to be in some kind of fiscal difficulty, that today, instead of hiring a bunch of people that can look at ways that they can spend their money differently, what they should do is not hire anyone and start tightening their belt and get rid of the frivolous programs that they support. So I hope that you do not at this time, and it seems very complicated. I mean, it seems like it could be a big pitfall. We don't know that today. So I'm saying today we do know that you can decline their offer to write a letter, and I hope you do that. Thank you.
Valerie Hood, 79 Dominga, Fairfax. I think I have to concur with the last two speakers. It feels like smoke and mirrors again. It's always about the money thing. I'm really understanding tonight the impact of the weight of increased tourism and housing density on our transportation infrastructure and the burden this places on local taxpayers. And perhaps this is a way to take the heat off of Representative McGuire. That is not something I think is our job to do. I urge you to vote no tonight on a resolution to endorse the Transportation Authority of Marin's effort to get a legislative waiver to permit an increase in Marin's already high sales tax. San Rafael City Council decided last night not to endorse this same resolution at this time. They demonstrated leadership in ensuring a transparent process in which jurisdictions take the time to consult the largest possible number of constituents, not consultants, before endorsing on their behalf. I hope that Fairfax will follow San Rafael's lead and stand up for its right to consult a broad constituency before endorsing on their behalf. TAM's time schedule requires Fairfax's immediate endorsement of their proposal without leaving time for constituent outreach or even to alert residents and businesses. If I hadn't read this tonight, I'd have no idea you guys were talking about this, and I bet we're looking at a 0.005% maybe of the citizens of Fairfax that know anything about this. If Fairfax endorses TAM's initiative, it would enable a process that would involve the expenditure or waste of considerable taxpayer funds to develop and promote a sales tax hike measure that will meet stiff taxpayer resistance. Sales taxes are regressive and hurt those most in need. There's ample evidence that the mood in Marin has changed. Voters are exhausted by too many recent tax measures, and many are feeling the financial pain. And after this election, we do know what we are facing. They want officials to stop seeking more revenues and focus instead on spending on the most important needs. Many taxpayers feel that their transportation dollars are not being spent by TAM on the right projects. You read it in the letters to the editor all the time. Struggling local businesses also risk being hurt by customers shopping elsewhere to avoid high sales taxes. Fairfax is prized as a place that's egalitarian, democratic, and values transparency, and I'm hopeful that in this spirit you will decline to endorse tonight TAM's efforts to gain a sales tax cap waiver. Please hit the pause button and take time gained to engage Fairfax citizens. Thank you.
So are there any other comments from the public? You'll get your chance in a minute. Okay, seeing none, we close the public comment section and bring it back up here.
Yeah, I have a quick question.
Yes?
I mean, like most things, I just don't know that much about TAM, as I don't know much about Marin Clean Energy, as I don't know much about what's going on in the school district more than what your average council member would know. So, John, you've been our long-time representative to TAM, so I got to tell you, despite the fact that I've known Stephanie for a long time and she could sell me anything she wants, because I have the highest regard for her work as a Mill Valley council member and also her work in the community generally. And as for Molly, I think your dad happens to be one of my favorite people on planet Earth. But I really want to hear how you're going to vote on this, because it's going to drive my consideration substantially.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you what TAM does do with the money is they try to look and see what serves the people in the community. I mean, as Stephanie was saying, a lot of the, you know, the TAM basically is created. I mean, I sit on the TAM board as Larry Bragman did before me, for a number of years. I think, Larry, I'm not sure how many years you were on it, but then I've been on there, I guess, the last three or four years, something like that. And basically what TAM does is they fund programs such as Safe Routes to School. They administer, you know, basically we go to them on bended knee and I try to advocate for things such as the crosswalks in town, when we talk about getting grants for different things that people want, such as sidewalk repairs, crosswalks in town, repaving of streets and things like that. We either fund it by, you know, such as we did with Major K in town, we passed a bond measure where we, in a sense, taxed ourselves by, you know, taxing and buying a bond, and then we're paying off that bond over a 20-year period. We did a fair amount of work on our local streets, which we pretty much used up that money 10 years ago. Something like that. We'll still be paying off that bond for a while. Basically, it costs a lot of money to keep our roads in good shape. It costs a lot of money to fund the bus system, the school, yellow school buses. We have been funding, and some of that money comes from TAM. That formula is going to be changing next year. Safe Routes to Schools is funded that way. And, the Park Aid grant is another example that came through TAM, and basically at the TAM board we try to figure out how to stretch the money that is available to what the various requests are. And I can tell you that the requests from all the different towns and cities in Marin, there's a laundry list of things that every community wants, and it's three or four times the size of what there's money for. And so there's, you know, basically you try to figure out how to allocate the money so everybody gets a little bit, so nobody gets what they want.
Just to cut to the chase and be mindful of Diane Hoffman's admonition that we sort of move these things along, am I hearing you to suggest that you'll be voting in favor of the sending of the letter?
Well, yeah, I mean, I think that might be a means to an end, and basically it allows the conversation to start going. I don't know that, I think that TAM could, I mean, that letter is going to Mike McGuire in order for us to say, well, for him to say, oh, okay, I've got support from local jurisdictions for raising this cap. As a form of state legislature. The other half of what Stephanie's asking is like, oh, should we start this conversation when we go and talk to communities to really widen the conversation to say, well, what is it that you want and how much are you willing to pay towards what you want?
So you're a yes on this incremental first step to send a letter?
Well, we have to see what that is. I mean, I agree that a sales tax is regressive. In Fairfax, it tends not to be. There's a lot of tourists and people with deeper pockets that do tend to spend more money, and they pay more sales tax. You know, the other alternative is what, a parcel tax? You know, I don't think TAM has the ability to do that. And I don't know that that's what we're talking about here.
So maybe to kind of move it forward, I very much respect Stephanie Moulton Peters. I believe you're chair of TAM and the work that TAM does, and I think Fairfax has benefited significantly from your advocacy on TAM and Larry's advocacy years before. I'm very supportive of TAM moving forward and doing an expenditure plan. I think the letter, I'm not supportive of the letter at this time. I think that there's a number of years that we have to work on this expenditure plan. And really, if it's next year that you come to us with the expenditure plan, then we'll see. Is it a half cent? Do we just need to renew the half cent? Or is TAM suggesting more? But we've got several years before this expires. So I think Senator McGuire wants this support letter to really bolster his efforts. But I don't feel comfortable supporting it at this time. But I do want to reiterate my support for TAM overall and appreciate Stephanie coming here.
Mm-hmm. So could you just explain, if we were to not write this letter in support for Senator McGuire tonight, what are the implications of that in terms of any doors that we might be closing? Because as I understand, unless all of us, I still haven't gotten the bottom line on this, but unless all of us are able to support that, then we're not going to send a letter to Senator McGuire from three jurisdictions, correct?
Yeah, that's
so
correct.
So what are the implications long term? Because the last thing I would want to do is make it less possible for TAM to be funded for the projects that I know are critical. I see the TAM projects have, you know, we have to continue. The bus programs, safe routes to schools, the road infrastructure projects, we can't not have them, and I think TAM's done an excellent job. But I do want to understand, because I do think that this is coming to us very, very much at the last minute. We're trying and grappling to understand this. I don't want to, continue to ask people to trust when it's very hard for us to even understand it. So I do want to know, though, are we closing doors that tonight makes such a big difference?
I'm sorry that this is so complicated, and it is. If Fairfax and Senator McGuire would like to have a unanimous support for this, if he does not have it, it's quite possible he would not choose not to carry the legislation to get the cap exemption. And that would leave us with renewing it at the current rate. And at such time, we do that. So that would be where we are. Yeah, thanks.
I'll take a run at this. What I'm hearing, and I'm listening carefully to you, John, because you are a representative, and I think Renee, who's our alternate, I'm hearing the same thing, which is these are essential and important projects. Things never get cheaper over time, and certainly to reallocate or re-up a tax at the same amount is logically gonna buy you less than it did so many years ago. Because this is a first step and merely begins a conversation that was begun, as I suggest, in the Prop 13 world, I think it cuts off a conversation or delays a conversation that I would rather provide TAM with the opportunity to begin with full-throatedly now. So what I'm hearing on the importance of these projects suggests to me that I would make a motion to authorize the mayor to send that letter of support to TAM.
I'm very torn. I do have some problems with how TAM has been, you know, allocating funds for some of the projects. I don't know that Fairfax gets its fair share of TAM funding. I'm concerned, and although it's not Measure A funds, what I think is a little bit inordinate funds from TAM going to support SMART, which doesn't benefit Fairfax, and which I have questions about as a viable transportation project. Putting that aside, I am concerned that the sales tax could go up as much as a penny from its half cent status now. On the other hand, we are living in an era of potentially even more draconian cuts at the federal level. So in some regards, sales taxes, local property taxes may be sort of all we have to fund projects of interest for us. And Stephanie does make a good point that funds spent elsewhere, though, do benefit us because we do travel on roads through San Anselmo, through San Rafael. We all tend to use the freeway. So to some extent, transportation funds going into a big pot, the pot getting allocated elsewhere, we still indirectly benefit to the extent we use the roads elsewhere. I also share Barbara's concern, though, that perhaps this isn't necessarily the time to go forward with increasing the limits. So I'm also very torn. I think I would probably vote in support of the letter, just kind of echoing David's concern that it allows some flexibility in the future. Doesn't mean that I would necessarily support a proposed tax increase for TAM, a sales tax, and I would probably condition any support depending on what that measure looks like in the future. So I do hear everyone's concerns about raising sales taxes. They are regressive. All of the emails that we've received tonight or today that I've seen were in opposition to this. But you know, it's not an easy decision, but I think I would tend to go in favor of supporting flexibility to raise the sales tax at a later date, and then let the voters decide at that time whether or not a particular tax measure is warranted on the merits of that proposed tax measure. So that's those are my 2 cents, or half cent, or quarter cent, whatever the.
So there's a motion. Is there a second on this to get going?
Can I just say?
I'm not hearing one right off the bat.
I just need to clarify. The idea of maintaining that flexibility is vital, and because my deep, deep concern about our transportation situation, about everything being really, really slowed by this idea that traffic has overtaken us, by the fact that sales tax may be regressive if you look at a macro definition. It isn't here in Fairfax, in that it allows for the people who come and shop here and purchase things here, which they do, to pay for a lot of what it is that we get in our for our tax money. I cannot vote for something that would hinder a potential opportunity to increase our transportation funds. They're so greatly needed. And so, as Peter said, and I echo that very strongly, this is nothing to do with whether I would vote in the end for this tax increase, but I do trust that TAM, with Stephanie at the helm, will make sure that this process and the community process of determining what we need and that it's equitably distributed so that Fairfax does get our share, which I do believe we are getting a good share. I would like a lot more. But I do believe that that process will be full-bodied and that that will give an opportunity for people to say, this is what we want, this is what we demand, and if we're not going to get it, then we're going to make our council say no to that sales increase, and we'll decide what to do from there. But I'm not going to cut it off now, which would, as you say, potentially kill that opportunity for McGuire to take this to the state. So that's where I'm at. So I would second your motion. I don't know if we're a little out of order because some people might have something to say, but I would second your motion.
Yeah. I mean, we're still kind of in our discussion stage. I mean, you're not, you've said your piece. But, I mean, I'm also, it's a conundrum because there are things that we want. There's not enough money to pay for it, and we have to cut, you know, come up with the money one way or another. I think my fellow council members have articulated the conundrum. I like your thought, Barbara, that SB1, I believe it is in another attempt to try to crack this nut in another way. And maybe, in fact, it takes both of these situations because I've seen what the budgets look like and we're coming up. You know, sometimes it's like, oh, well, we can pay for 28% of what we want, or, you know, it depends on what you're talking about on the plate each time, but it usually comes out around there. And so you pretty much have to pick and choose what we're, you know, I mean, come up there every time and talk about the stuff that Fairfax needs every time, and we get a little piece of what we need. So it is a letter. I think it sends a signal to say, hey, let's fight for our local community to our representative. And ultimately, the voters will be able to decide this. And should we let the voters decide? I think we probably should. If we don't write the letter, we're not letting our voters decide. So, letters for legislation. Yeah. That's a good point. So I guess there's a motion on the floor. Weinsoff and Goddard. And the motion is to endorse the letter, right? The clerk is looking at me to clarify, so I thought I would. So I would call for a vote on this. Then all those in favor of this?
Aye.
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 Respectfully, no.